Let's spend about 10 minutes talking Kansas State football, basketball, and recruiting on KSO Today, a free daily podcast brought to you by K-State Online. Welcome to another week, another Monday, another installment of KSO Today on February 10th, 2020. KSO Today is brought to you by both People's State Bank, with its 10 branches and 17 ATMs throughout the state of Kansas, as well as Legacy Insurance Solutions, with a branch found here in Manhattan at 2401 Seth Child Road here in Manhattan, 2401 Seth Child Road, or shoot, you call them on the telephone at 785-789-3441. People's State Bank, Legacy Insurance Solutions, always appreciate their support here for KSO Today, KSO Show, all of that stuff. Let's move on to what we have to talk about on this Monday, and there's quite a bit, of course. It is a couple days old at this point, but K-State did lose to Iowa State. I believe it was 73-63 Saturday night in Ames. We were at Hilton Coliseum for that game. Honestly, a very disappointing loss for K-State. I had the Wildcats. I think I picked K-State to win for only the second time in Big 12 play this year. I had them picked to beat Oklahoma and then picked them again to win last night in Ames. Saturday night in Ames. I was certainly wrong as K-State gets down. I believe I mentioned 21 in the first half. Another really, really rough start for K-State, where they have to dig out of a huge hole. It happened, you know, against Texas Tech, against West Virginia on the road. It's happened multiple times this year. They're able to do it mostly successfully. Got it back to four, got themselves in the game, had multiple shots to hit, you know, a three here and there to get it down to two or three. They never did it, never got over the hump, as you've heard a lot. And K-State lost to a team that was equally flawed. They had the same record going in. This was a team K-State needed to beat on the road, or at least it has to beat teams like that on the road the rest of the way to really have any chance of having a respectable season. You know, we talked going into it that K-State probably had to take two out of three on the road against Iowa State, Oklahoma State, and TCU. Now they're 0-1 in those three, so they almost have to win the last two, and it's going to be tough. And like I talked about on KSO Today last week, for those close games, you know, the wins against West Virginia and Oklahoma, and then the competitive games against, you know, the likes of Baylor, West Virginia, Alabama, etc., to really mean something, it needed to turn into wins against teams like Iowa State, and that didn't happen Saturday night in Ames. So that's a troubling sign for this K-State team that's already had a rough season. We'll see how it goes going forward. I want to give a lot of credit to Cartier Jada, who did get reinserted into the starting lineup, scored 24 points on a much more efficient, you know, 7-15 shooting, was really the only Wildcat offensively who could create his own shot and make things happen consistently against the Cyclones. He played really well offensively. Three turnovers isn't a giant problem against three assists, particularly when you're scoring as well as Cardi did. Came and talked to the media last night. Excuse me, I keep saying last night. It was two nights ago in Ames after the game, and that was appreciated. I thought he gave K-State a chance. You know, he really did in the second half of making shots for K-State, getting back in the game. They couldn't find a secondary score, though. Couldn't do enough to overcome the huge deficit they created against Iowa State. We do have a media availability today at 2:30 to talk about the Oklahoma State game. Flando is a very nice man, and right when I started this, he sent me a text. He said, "Hey, Dale," that's what we call it. He calls me. Stay home from this. I'll go cover it today, so I guess I'm going to. Very kind of him. So Flando will have full video coverage of the K-State press conference today, late this afternoon, early evening on KSO. This Oklahoma State game tomorrow, man, I think must win is the most overused term in sports, and I avoid using it like the plague because, like I always say, in a literal sense, it's not a must win until losing the game, you know, literally costs you a championship, ends your season, etc., because things can always happen. That said, if you're taking it in a less literal sense, this is pretty much a must win for K-State against Oklahoma State at home. The Cowboys had been the worst team in the league this year, although they've played better the last two. And I'm not sure it's a sure thing K-State beats Oklahoma State in Manhattan. I'll probably pick them to do so, and I think it's likely to happen. The Wildcats will be at least a slight favorite. But it's not a sure thing. I think it's going to be a challenge. There'll be a lot of pressure on K-State in this game. For Oklahoma State, of course, there's pressure on them too, because this season has been more disappointing for them from an outsider perspective, at least outside expectations, than it has K-State. But for K-State, this is the kind of game they're going to be expected to win at home. And there will be a lot of pressure on the Wildcats against the Cowboys. I'll be excited to see that game and see how K-State does. Maybe more interesting, more exciting stuff. We did drive back yesterday, being Sunday, through Des Moines, Iowa, which I haven't been through Des Moines in a long time. It's an awfully nice town. It seemed pretty, well, pretty, for lack of a better term. We went to West Des Moines to say, I believe it was Valley High School, and speak with K-State commitment Jaden Williams. Listed as an athlete, that's what he is. You know, we didn't get a chance. How do I say this the right way? There's just not going to be a further answer provided really until Jaden Williams gets to K-State about a position for him. Certainly looking at, you know, linebacker, running back, one of those two. Talked a lot about running back Brian Anderson. his position coach, that kind of stuff. Just a great kid. I know you expect me to say that about every kid we talk to. I understand that, but he really was. I'm just so impressed. You know, I asked him when he rolled up, drove up by himself. Guy's 17 years old, comes up to these three guys he doesn't really know from out of state. Camera set up, microphones, and he just wasn't nervous at all. He was so comfortable with us. He was a lot of fun. He was really nice, just really, really impressive in that setting, in my opinion. He looks great physically. I mean, he's a legit 6'1". I don't think he's 6'2". I think 6'1 is a correct height for him. He's probably right at 200 pounds, if not a hair below. But, man, he has a lot of lean muscle on his frame already. Just really impressed with how he looks. I think he's legit 200 pounds. There's not a ton of bulk on him right now, but what he has is lean muscle and good weight, you can tell, and the frame is great. There's been some chatter that this guy could look like Mike McCoy a couple years into the program. I mean, that's a lot for me to ask because Mike McCoy was a physical beast, but this kid does have that kind of frame, and he has a great build right now to where, sure, maybe when he's a redshirt freshman after a couple of years in the strength program that he is 6'1", 225 and playing at that weight. K-State loves him. He is a heavy K-State commit. There was some talk off video about other schools recruiting him. You saw him say on video he's committed. It was just as strong, if not stronger, off video. So I think K-State fans don't have to worry about that, even if the hometown schools, Iowa, Iowa State, et cetera, do come calling. I'm not going to give you a lot more on that because selfishly I want you to watch the video that Grant Flanders put some work in on Jaden Williams to produce, and the work that Derek Young does on those I think is really, really good. And most importantly, the work that Jaden Williams did to give us his time, his effort, and to represent himself so well. Give it a watch if you don't mind. A couple other things to look for on the site, either today or recently. Derek wrote an update that I put up yesterday morning, Sunday morning, that gets hidden sometimes on Sunday, on wide receiver from Texas, Keegan Johnson, a 5.73 star. That's the highest three-star you can be without going to four. So that's a name worth watching that DU had a good update on. Also this morning, about a half hour ago, I released his commit watch number 2 for the class of 2021. So a number of names to keep an eye on to commit either to K-State shortly or what other schools to be looking at. And this was a couple days ago, but it also kind of got hidden during the Iowa State basketball coverage. Derek always does a nice job of looking at the new rosters when they come out, breaking them down in case they did release the spring football roster. Not a lot of changes. I think no changes yet from heights and weights, which is too bad just because it's interesting. And Derek will break that down a lot when that comes out. But you get to see, you know, the name changes, the jersey numbers. You got a couple new D tackles wearing single digits, which is fantastic. Robert Hintz and Derek Newton both in the single digits. You got to love that. And I think Gainis at the end were in 13, which DUI was excited about. So if you get all these new JUCO kids to come in and play early, you'll have some great looking numbers on the defensive line. If people are annoyed by hearing me talk about uniforms, I get just as bad about jersey numbers and what you should pick there. So I'm sorry for that. But yeah, those are the things you can look for sure on the site today. Like I said, Flanders is heading to basketball media availability this afternoon around 2:30. You'll have that. Future travel plans from KSO. I will be headed by myself. I think Natalie's going to go with me, actually. But by myself to K-State TCU this weekend in Fort Worth. We'll be covering that one in person, of course. And then after that, like I said, on the 20th and 21st, I could be getting the dates a little bit wrong, but I think it's the 20th and 21st this month. We head to St. Louis to watch K-State basketball commits and rivals 150 members Davion Bradford and Luke Kasubke play in person. So we really look forward to that. That's all I have for you right now on this Monday edition of KSO Today. You'll hear more from me this week, but a lot of Derek Young. You'll hear Flando Friday this Friday. He has promised me, so not a ton of Matt Hall on KSO Today this week, which is probably great for everybody. I appreciate your time. Thank you for listening. Hope you enjoyed KSO Today, and have a great Monday.